in C class. So non-metallic minerals, in which we discussing regarding as a mica. 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 Mica and the rock minerals such as a limestone, dolomite, gypsum, magnesite, etc. are the non-metallic minerals. So first as a mica. Mica has a major use for its electrical and electronic industries. Electrical and electronic industries due to its excellent dielectric strength. Dielectric strength. Yes, Amritpal. Yes. Directly comes towards as a conventional sources of energy. The sources of energy. Sources of energy. Okay, thank you. Sources of energy. Energy as a fuel is a major requirement of modern production and modern life. Energy can be the both manual or animal and mechanical or electrical. Energy is indispensable for transport industry. Industry can be energy can be generated from the fuel minerals like as coal, petroleum, natural gas, radioactive substances like uranium, thorium, and from the electricity. Energy resources are of the two types, conventional sources of energy and non-conventional sources of energy. Conventional sources of energy and non-conventional. Conventional, those sources, non-conventional sources are, non-conventional sources of energy are those which are used in present, just in a recent in time, for human development. Clear? Conventional sources of energy, most number of conventional sources of energy are the most number of energy minerals, such kind of the minerals which are categorized under conventional are the not the eco-friendly, like coal, petroleum, natural gas. But in the other side, hydroelectricity has also categorized under the conventional sources, which is as the eco-friendly, which is as the eco-friendly. Clear? So let's start from the first conventional sources of energy. So as mentioned, as we mentioned, as the coal, petroleum, natural gas are the conventional sources of energy. They have been used for energy production for quite some time, for a longer duration of time. For a longer duration of time. So first, conventional sources of energy, they have been used for energy production for quite some time. Except water, these sources of energy, coal, petroleum, natural gas, are the non-replenishable or exhaustible, except water. They cause as environmental pollution, they are expensive and unevenly distributed over the earth. Let's start from the first, coal. Coal as the first conventional source of energy. Coal is the prime source of a commercial power for industrial and domestic needs. Okay. Okay, Jasleen. Coal. Coal is the prime source of a commercial power. Yes. So coal, this is as a basically used for a commercial purposes. Commercial purposes at present. Presently as a coal used for a industrial domestic requirements, and it contributes 60% of energy production in our country. Energy production in our country has based upon a coal, means thermal power stations. Thermal power stations, where the coal used as a raw material for generation of electricity, it completes our 60% of energy requirement. Coal is the most abundantly available fossil fuel, which has formed through the decomposition of dead plants and animals under the sedimentary rocks. It is a form due to as a compression of plant materials over millions of years. Coal is found in varying forms of depending on the degree of a compression depth and time of the time in which as a such fossils they buried beneath the layers of earth crust. There are generally as a four categories of a coal are there, which are categorized on the basis of a carbon content. On a basis of a carbon content, anthracite, which is as the highest quality of black coal, anthracite, highest quality of black coal, which has a maximum carbon content more than the 80%. 80% carbon content is present in a anthracite. Such kind of a coal used in a locomotives, engines, railway engines, locomotives, locomotives, clear? Not in a normal automobiles, clear Amritpal? Not in normal automobiles as a locomotives for which as a generally used as such kind of a coal. This kind of a coal, anthracite, is generally found in a parts of a Jammu and Kashmir. It gives the maximum heat found generally in a Jammu and Kashmir. Second is a bituminous. Second category of a coal is the bituminous, which has been buried deep and is subjected to increased temperature and pressure, which removes the moisture content. It has a 60 to 80% of a carbon content. 60 to 80% of carbon content. This kind of a coal basically used in a smelting of iron, in a manufacturing of steel. Such kind of a coal is basically used. It is as a commercially used for a metallurgical industries. Bituminous coal is mostly found in a Chota Nagpur belt. Bituminous coal found in Chota Nagpur belt and in river valleys of a Son, Godavari and Mahanadi. Son, Godavari and Mahanadi, anthracite found in a Jammu and Kashmir, whereas the bituminous category of a coal found in a Chota Nagpur plateau, Son Valley, Mahanadi Valley and Godavari Valley. Third, lignite, L-I-G-N-I-T-E, lignite. It is as a low-graded brown coal, which is soft in nature with high moisture content. Lignite is mainly mined in a Neyveli mines of Tamil Nadu. Used for a thermal power production. Electricity, for generation of electricity. Presently in Punjab, there are the 5 thermal power stations are there, from which as a one is stopped their production. Bathinda, which is the first thermal power station of Punjab, it stopped their production because of increasing as a lead content. The other 4 still are function. Goindwal, Rajpura, near in a Mohali, they are still as a working in a present to complete our energy requirement. Next, peat, P-E-A-T, fourth category of coal, its formation is the latest, means as such kind of a coal, it just formed in a since last 50,000 years back. Such kind of a coal is generally used for a domestic purposes. Not for industrial uses, because the emission of such kind of a coal releases the smoke in a large quantities of a smoke released by the heat. Just only Amritpal, just It just only asked the 50,000 years. Clear? 50,000 years only. So that kind of a coal consisting the less than the 40% of a carbon content. 40% of carbon content is present in a 40% of a carbon content present in a that category of a coal, peat, which is basically used for a domestic uses, for domestic needs. For domestic needs, it has low carbon and a high moisture content and low heating capacity. It emits the too much of smoke when burnt. It is also found in a southern parts of a Kashmir. Southern parts of Kashmir. Longer the duration of a formation of a coal means as their quality. It directly influence on their quality. In our country, there are two ages of a coal has generally found. Gondwana age of coal and tertiary age of coal. Gondwana age of coal and tertiary age of coal. These two ages of coal generally found in our country. Gondwana and tertiary age of coal. Gondwana age of coal, that kind of a coal which formed around 200 million years ago. 200 million years ago. 200 million years ago. Gondwana age. Remember Gondwana, that age when Pangaea disintegrated into the two large land masses. Supercontinent divided into two land masses, Gondwana land and Angara land at that time. And the rest of the coal, 30% of India's coal has found in the age of a tertiary age. Tertiary age of coal. Clear? Tertiary age of coal when the Himalayas came into existence. Just recent in time. Clear? So Gondwana age of a coal, it generally found in different river valleys. For example, first Son Valley, S-O-N, Son Valley of Chhattisgarh, Son Valley of Chhattisgarh and Madhya Pradesh. In Chhattisgarh as a Korba mines, K-O-R-B-A, Korba, and in Madhya Pradesh as Singrauli. In Madhya Pradesh as Singrauli, Korba of Chhattisgarh, Singrauli of Madhya Pradesh, located at the Son Valley known for the Gondwana age of coal. Second, Damodar Valley of West Bengal. Its important mines are Rani Ganj of West Bengal and Jharia and Bokaro of Jharkhand. Jharia and Bokaro of Jharkhand. Bokaro of Jharkhand. Jharia and Bokaro of Jharkhand. Jharia and Bokaro of Jharkhand in Damodar Valley region of West Bengal. Third, Godavari Valley, Singareni. Godavari Valley of Andhra Pradesh, Singareni. Singareni. Singareni of Andhra Pradesh. Next, Mahanadi Valley of Odisha, known for the Talcher Mines. Talcher of Odisha. of Odisha, known for the Gondwana age of coal. Next is a Vardha Valley of Maharashtra. Vardha, Vardha, Vardha Valley of Maharashtra. So I'm again repeating, as a Gondwana age of a coal, it has generally extracted through the Son Valley, which includes as a Korba mines of Chhattisgarh, Singrauli of Madhya Pradesh, Korba and Singrauli of Madhya Pradesh, Singrauli of Madhya Pradesh. Second, as the Mahanadi Valley of Talcher in Orissa. Third, Damodar Valley of Raniganj in West Bengal. Jharia and Bokaro of Jharkhand. Damodar Valley. Next, as a Singrani of Godavari in Andhra Pradesh. Then the next is a Vardha Valley of Maharashtra. Tertiary age of coal, it is generally found in Assam, Arunachal Pradesh. Meghalaya, Nagaland, and Assam. Next, after till there any questions? Till that of the extent matter discussed in a 10th D class, or a 9C is equivalent to a 10D. Now next, as a crude oil, petroleum, crude oil. Next, conventional sources of energy, as the crude oil or petroleum. After the coal, petroleum or a mineral oil is the major source of energy in India. Generally, as a petroleum extracted through the crude oil, that crude oil extracted through the drilling process of mining. Drilling process of mining through which as a crude oil extracted in our country. Crude oil contains several impurities. Crude oil in world market, crude oil as selling, which has consisting the several impurities. Such impurities are separated in oil refineries. Smelting is a process through which as a impurities of iron separated. So same as crude oil, their impurities are separated at a place named as oil refineries. After the refining of a crude oil, various number of useful products are obtained, like diesel. Products which are obtained after the refinement of a crude oil are diesel, gasoline, jet fuel, lubricants, petroleum coke, synthetic rubber, plastics, kerosene, etc. I'm again repeating, as a diesel, products which are extracted after the refinement of a crude oil are diesel, kerosene, lubricants, synthetic rubber, plastics, petroleum coke, jet fuel, gasoline, etc. Gasoline, etc. Such refineries which are providing as a raw material for industries, those industries are known as a petrochemical industries. These industries are known as the petrochemical industries. And these petrochemical industries are also known as a nodal industry. Nodal industry. Petrochemical industries are known as the nodal industries. Mining is a killer industry. Iron and steel industries are the basic industries. Petrochemical industries are the nodal industries. Why? Because these industries, their products are used to increase the production. Iron and steel used for providing the base. That's why the basic industries. But the petrochemical industries are nodal, which are interlinked, which are supportive to increase the production, like the fertilizers. Fertilizers are manufactured on the basis of a material extracted to the oil refineries. Such fertilizers used for increasing the production. Fertilizers used to increase in production in agriculture fields. Cosmetics, pharmaceuticals, synthetic textiles. All these are the industries which are associated with the oil refineries. These industries are associated with the oil refineries. That's why they are known as a nodal industries. These industries are known as a nodal industries. Clear? The use of oil for power production is considered efficient as it emits the little smoke, leaves no ash, and can be used up to the last drop. Occurrences of petroleum in India is associated with the fault traps. Fault traps, which are lies in anticline structures of folded mountains. When the compression forces are act beneath the layers of earth crust, due to compressional forces, faults are appear. The rises portion of faults are known as anticlines. Rises portion of a fault is known as anticlines. These are the anticlines. So these areas, these regions of faults, they are the rich in petroleum. They are rich in petroleum occurrences. The fault traps and the anticlines in sedimentary rocks formations of tertiary time period. In regions of folding anticlines or domes, oil is trapped in the crest of upfolded part of a fold mountain. Oil-bearing layers is a porous limestone or a sandstone through which the oil can spillage. Oil can percolate beneath as the layers, but such oil has lies in above of non-porous rocks. Non-porous, such kind of rocks which are not allowed to penetrate the oil towards the deeper sections of earth. So oil has generally lies in above of non-porous rocks, but that oil, it penetrates to the porous rocks. Porous rocks, when the fossils are trapped beneath the layers of earth crust in sedimentary rocks. Generally in our country, there are the offshore mines are the more comparatively the onshore. Offshore mines associated with the crude oil, in which as a Bombay High contributes as a 63% of a total production. 63% of a total production. Gujarat 18%, Ankleshwar of Gujarat 18%, and Assam as a 16%. Our country's total energy consumption has completes. Its 60% of consumption has directly completes to the OPEC industries. Our country, 60% of oil consumption completes to the OPEC industries, oil producing eastern countries. Means we are importing the crude oil from Gulf countries. Remaining 40% has completed through these three areas. Bombay High, Gujarat, and Assam. Bombay High, which is located in the Arabian Sea, at that place of Arabian Sea, where the permanent ship is located. The name of a ship is a Sagar Samrat. Sagar Samrat. It is as the name of a ship through which as the through drilling oil extracted on a surface of oceans towards the above the surface of water bodies. So our 63% of out of the 40 to 63% as directly provided through the Bombay High, 18% as a Gujarat and Assam as a 16%. And our national production of the or a national consumption of a crude oil has directly completes to the 60% has directly completes to the Gulf countries. Major offshore mines of a crude oil in India are Bombay High. Offshore mines of crude oil in Maharashtra are Bombay High, comma, Aliabet, 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 and third as a Basin, Bassein. Aliabet is a one of the islands of a Bombay. Bombay is a conglomeration. It's a assemblage of a 7 islands. So one of it as a Aliabet, Aliabet, which is known for the extraction of a crude oil. Third is a Basin, Bassein, Bassein. Clear? Second offshore mine in Gujarat as Ankleshwar. Second as Ankleshwar. Third in Assam, Digboi. Third in Assam, Digboi. Naharkatia and Moran Hugrijan. Except these three mined areas, offshore located mines, one more is there, Tamil Nadu, near Kaveri Delta. Kaveri Delta. Clear? Demand for the oil and oil products is consistently increasing, and we need to import the 40 to 50% of requirements. With the rising prices and the exhaustible nature, we must look for the alternate sources of power or non-conventional sources of energy. For example, the number of the automobiles are increasing day by day. Clear, Amritpal? Number of automobiles are increasing day by day. Number of the automobiles are increasing day by day as per the increasing in automobiles. The dependence on a petroleum is increasing. So let's we continue. Till there, any questions? Petroleum. Now next is the natural gas. Any questions? Natural gas are generally lies in areas which are having as a crude oil reserves. Crude oil reserves. Whereas the crude oil reserves are there in such areas as a natural gas is generally found. Natural gas is associated mostly with the oil deposits and even without it. It is one of the main sources of electricity contributing the 10% of a total energy consumption. Our country's 10% of a total energy consumption directly completes through the those plants where the natural gas is used as a source of energy. As a source of energy, natural gas is a main industrial raw material in petrochemical industries. It is considered an important environment friendly because of the low carbon dioxide emissions through its burning. The main areas of natural gas reserves in India are Krishna Godavari Basin of Andhra Pradesh, Krishna Godavari basin of Andhra Pradesh. Krishna Godavari basin of Andhra Pradesh. Second, Mumbai offshore mines of Maharashtra. Mumbai offshore mines of Maharashtra. Mumbai offshore mines of Maharashtra. Mines of Maharashtra. Third, Gulf of Cambay fields of Gujarat. Gulf of Cambay fields in Gujarat. Jaisalmer areas of Rajasthan. Kaveri Valley of Tamil Nadu. Andaman and Nicobar Islands. Natural gas is generally transporting through as the pipeline transportation in our country. India's longest gas pipeline as the Hazira, Vijaypur, and Jagdishpur. In some of the books, they will be as written as a B. At the place of a B, they will be written as the B. Both are accepted. Bijapur or Vijaypur. Hazira in Gujarat, Vijaypur in Madhya Pradesh, Jagdishpur in Uttar Pradesh. In Uttar Pradesh, associated with the transportation of a natural gas in our country. Natural gas. One of the gas pipeline, it has coming from the Gujarat towards the Jalandhar. Gujarat to Jalandhar in Punjab. Clear? Next, as the natural gas is basically used for two of the purposes, as we discussed, as a domestic purposes for which as LPG, liquefied petroleum gas, is used for industrial uses, for automobiles, for the vehicles, as a CNG. Compressed natural gas. So this much for today. Any questions?